I really want to. But should I? सेंस नहीं बनता, थोड़ा थोड़ा एडवेंचरस है. But I have to. I'm gonna go on this trip.
I am Kriti Vij and I love traveling. Honestly, lockdown ki wajah se I couldn't step out. So I suddenly realized that I have a lot more time on my hands than I bargained for. I discovered my love for documentaries and finding out about things that I'm generally oblivious to. Nature documentaries in particular had a huge impact on me and got me thinking about the various environmental problems that we've caused. It also hit me that our apathy stems out of ignorance. Agar issues ka pata hi nahi hai, then how can we be part of the solution? Once the lockdown eased up, I decided to find out what ecotourism was all about. So welcome to Green Escapes, a show where we come across a variety of environmentally conscious people, learn how to be better travelers, and have fun while making the world a better place. Some accounts at the current rate of deforestation, 5 to 10% of the tropical forest species will become extinct every decade. Imagine. All of this because of the environmental degradation caused by us humans. As I thought more about my impact on our planet and how I can improve it, one thing that startled me was the waste we generate while traveling. Some reports suggest that tourism and hotels in India account for about 30% of the waste from over 60 million tons generated by the nation annually.
Ab travel karna to chhod nahi sakte, right? But here's what we can do. We can actually be more responsible and reduce our carbon footprint. It's extremely essential to protect our tourist hotspots that we really want to visit. So I figured, why not travel and not harm the environment? And actually also learn about ecotourism on the way. Oh, thank you. And if this is how it's going to start, then I'm in for a great treat. I had no idea where to start. So I decided, let's focus on how I want to travel. And my friends at MG suggested me the best travel companion, the MG ZS EV. And because I'm such a big fan of road trips, I actually wanted to see how much CO2 emission do we actually save by using an electric vehicle. So come, let me show you my ride. Planning out my trip, I actually found out that Chennai is one of the leading hotspots for electric vehicle infrastructure in India. This is actually one of the many things that Tamil Nadu is doing for sustainable travel. So it felt right that this should be the first place that I should start this trip. Hello, MG.
I'm listening.
How am I looking today?
You look amazing.
Ah, so sweet. Thank you. Now I'm going to drive down from Chennai to Auroville. I charge my car in Chennai for a couple of hours and I have around 65% battery in my car. And we have to cover 160 kilometers. I'm sure we'll comfortably reach our destination. You know the best part about road trips is कि तुम कहीं पे भी रुक सकते हो. Like this. Well-known spaces तो सब जाते हैं, but to actually stop at a spot that speaks to you, that's really something else. So now I'm headed to Auroville to meet my old friend John, who's actually an environmentalist and a global peace ambassador.
I'm hoping to learn how to be a more responsible traveler from him. He's taking me to this place called Sadhna Forest.
I'm super excited.
Sadhna Forest is an independent and self-reliant community established to plant trees in the forest around Auroville. To understand the Sadhna Forest better, John has arranged a tour for us with one of the long-term volunteers here, Sheikh. So let's see what he has in store for us.
So how long have you been here?
I've been here for about a year and a half now, living here as a resident.
Yeah.
But I came here for the first time just for one day, just like you guys.
Yeah.
About 2 years ago.
Wow.
And then I came back for a month because this place really interested me.
Yeah.
So I came back for 1 month. And then, you know, I've been here for the last year and a half.
That's amazing.
Yeah. There's a lot of things to learn about this place. And there's a lot of things to... that this place teaches you about yourself.
Yeah.
So many people say that Sadhna Forest is not just a place to grow trees, but also a place to grow people.
Wow.
And that's why we choose to live here.
Love it. That's really nice.
Yeah.
So should we start the tour?
Yeah, I guess since we're here, we can see that we have our solar panels right over there.
Okay.
This is where we generate all of our electricity to meet the needs of our community.
The Sadhna Forest community clearly does not have to worry about our ever-rising electricity bills. They create their own electricity using renewable sources like solar panels and pedal power, among others.
Okay, so these are our electric bikes. Instead of consuming electricity to take you places, you just cycle on them, exercise, and they make electricity for us.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
So should we make some electricity for you right now?
Yeah, go for it.
Awesome.
Get on it.
Happy to do it. Chalo.
Please, yeah.
Okay. Produced enough electricity for you.
It takes a lot of energy to produce energy, yeah?
It does. So where are we headed next?
So we're going to our main hut.
Okay.
That's basically our living room, our dining room, anything that's not your bedroom, basically.
Lovely.
So it's the place where we have all of our meals, our community events, gatherings, workshops, everything.
Let's go.
Yeah, shall we?
The main hut in Sadhna Forest is where all the magic happens. One can read books, attend community events, host classes, and perhaps best of all, break bread with the community members here.
Oh, wow.
So this is...
Look at that.
This is the structure. This is a place where we have, like I said, all 21 meals a week. We often host, actually every Friday, we have a kind of a 2-hour-long tour of Sadhna Forest, followed by a documentary and a dinner for sometimes more than 300 people. So you're welcome to join for that point whenever you want.
In the last 40 years, we have lost 4x the size of Europe. To understand the gravity of the issue, since 2016, 26 million hectares of forest have been lost in a single year. And that is one football field of forest lost every single second. You could see this mud pool, like what they have done.
Yeah.
It's actually storing water instead of just letting it flow elsewhere.
Yeah.
And there is no scarcity of water.
Yeah.
The trees are fed by the water and the biodiversity has come back. You could hear the birds. Mm. Yeah, that's it, how good the place is.
Yeah, it's amazing, you know, what a small group of people that have the same vision for sustainability can achieve. It's amazing.
Sach bolu to before coming here, I was slightly skeptical about the idea of living in a forest. But after having spent some time here and after talking to the community members, it seems quite doable. In fact, the whole experience was so fulfilling that I'm sure I'll be here for a longer period of time sometime in the near future. Well thought out core values like unschooling, where they push kids to learn based on where their curiosity drives them. Gift economy, where people share their skills and valuables with each other without any agenda, and living on a plant-based diet to reduce the burden on the environment makes this community feel very wholesome. The fact that they are tackling the deforestation problem directly gives a very strong sense of purpose to the volunteers. The desire to make the world a better place comes out in every conversation you have with them. I expected to learn a lot on my trip. But that learning would be this much fun, ye nahi socha tha. Mujhe lagta hai that it's very important for us to keep learning to have fruitful lives. Ekdam se I feel like a little kid in a nursery learning the alphabet. It's all exciting and scary at the same time. Knowing that if I implement what I learn here in my life, I leave the world a better place than I found it, is very motivating.
If you want to learn more about ecotourism and if you want me to explore more such places, then please share this video with all your friends. And don't forget to comment below and tell me about your experiences. I'd love to read it.